victim. Hey, you're not one of those things out there. Who the hell are you? And I bet he told you it's the Creator's will for you to risk your ass instead of him, right? Well, good luck with that. I'd give you a hand, but no thanks. I may look like a corpse, but I'm partial to living. Guess the outfit gives that away, huh? I never did buy into that religious mumbo-jumbo with the robes and all that shit. It gets lonely out in the wastes, okay? And I don't have to tell you, that Bright's group has got some fine-looking goulettes in it. Huh? Or maybe I would have to tell you. Anyway, I helped them out, and they kept me supplied with ammo and pleasant company. Huh. Well, you're polite. I'll give you that. If this was just between you and me, I'd do as you ask. But it's not. I had a friend with me when those mutant bastards came out of nowheres. She panicked and ran the wrong direction. Further into the basement. She's probably dead. But I ain't leaving until I know for sure. I'd have gone looking myself, except I wouldn't last a minute out there. You, on the other hand, seem pretty resourceful. Find my friend, and I'll get out of your way. Thanks. Let me know what you find out. Here's hoping she's up.
That Antler? We have a visitor. An assassin, more like. I say kill it, Antler, for safe's sake. Hmm? Okay, Antler, I'll ask. Hi, human. Why you come here? A human who is friend to ghouls? Suspicious. You mean the ones upstairs? Antler used intercom, told them stay put. But they want to come down in basement anyways. I cannot allow. My kin are not right in head like I am. They attack you on sight. Ghouls too. They crazy. Your ghoul friends have to wait until you find what Antler brought us to get. Good. Antler brought us here for a reason. Why was that, Antler? Right, a piece of paper, shipment invoice, hundreds of stealth boys sent here a long time ago. But stealth boys must be in the one room, one we don't search yet, the one we can't search. Yes, Antler says we leave here as soon as we get stealth boys. Let me give you key. Antler had me lock the door. The ghoul inside, not expecting a human. Maybe he don't shoot you. Maybe he will. Antler sings for stealth boys. Have you found them? Keep looking. Antler wants Nightkin to have them.
I have to kill him, buddy. down there?
That's none of your business, Smoothskin. Jason was very clear. Get rid of the demons, then report back. He didn't tell you to poke around down there. Got it?
Let's hope you do.
What is it? I'll sit tight.
Did you find my friend? I see. Well, spare me the details. Damn it. I'm gonna miss that crooked yellow smile. All right. You did your part, so I'll do mine. Look around up here if you want. I'm gonna make a break for topside.
Antler sings for stealth boys. Have you found them? Liar! The envoy said stealth boys here. Antler read it out loud to me. But invoice note said stealth boys were here. Why can't that note be true? What, Antler? But human could be lying. Is stealing the stealth boys for itself. Oh, Antler, you trust so easy. Your lucky day, human. Antler, believe you. Nightkin will follow the new note to find stealth boys. Better be there. Antler is sad, human. Nightkin, go now. Find stealth boys in other places.
I don't kill people unless I have to. sorry. We don't talk to outsiders. Talk to Jason if you have business here.
Is the way clear?
Praise the Creator, and bless you, Wanderer.
The way is clear. I will lead my flock through the basement to the sacred site. I hope you will come find us there, Wanderer.
So nice that I don't have to sneak around this place. And I keep on going around in circles.
I've got your back. Fine by me. Fine by me.
tech sick.
I waited to speak with you one last time before I descended to the launch pad, Wanderer. I want you to know that we will remember for all eternity how you delivered us to the threshold of the Great Journey. Our preparations are nearly complete, but the rockets that will carry us to salvation are yet missing vital components. If you would still help us, Wanderer, speak to Chris. He can tell you what is missing. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always. Yes, the rockets will convey us to our promised land in the far beyond. Vision upon vision has confirmed it. I understand your concerns, friend, and I thank you for voicing them. But the Creator's will for us has been made manifest. After all that you have done for us, I suppose you deserve to know everything. When Chris came to us, we tried to convince him that he was human. But this only angered him. He seemed lost. We decided to let him stay with us for a few days, over the course of which we learned that his technical skills far surpassed our own. It became clear that the Creator had sent him to us to ensure the success of the Great Journey. Equally clear was that Chris should labor in blessed ignorance of his humanity and his inability to make the journey himself. It is no coincidence that two humans have been vital to the success of the Great Journey. It is my belief that the Creator sent you and Chris to expiate the sins of your kind against mine. Your redeemers both. Such is the Creator's will. Vision upon vision has shown me that, were Chris to accompany us, he would die in minutes. The radiation around the launch pad alone would kill Chris in minutes. The radioactivity of the far beyond is much stronger. I take no pleasure in hiding the truth from Chris, but it is the Creator's will to which I must submit. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Hey. Jason says that I am to cooperate with you on the final tasks necessary to launch the Great Journey. I'm the Flock's resident engineer. I've always been good with machines. Jason... When I joined the Flock, Jason made it clear that he wanted me to supervise the repairs, not do them myself. It would be a waste of my gifts to work on just one system at a time. From up here, I've been able to supervise. I thought we were past all that, Smoothskin. But you just can't resist the chance to mess with me. I was human once, you know. Grew up in Vault 34, northeast of here. Nice upbringing if you like assault rifles and target practice. But oh, you prefer machines that don't shoot people? Not so nice then. Who should maintain the Vault's reactor? Hauser? Mitchell? No! Make it Haversom. He likes machines. Haversom won't mind getting irradiated. Haversom won't mind mutating. He's already ugly as it is.
Haversome won't mind when his hair starts falling out after a few years. There's no connection, Haversome. You're neurotic. Bald? You call this bald, Smoothskin? I'm a monster. A monster! Obviously. It's taken months, but I've nearly got them in working order. Soon they'll take us to the far beyond. I was skeptical at first, of course, being a man of science. But Jason is certain, and I believe in Jason. I was close to completing work on the rockets before we were driven into hiding on the top floor. Two components were missing. A quantity of isotope 239 igniting agent, and a set of thrust control modules. The igniting agent is highly radioactive and decays quickly. That's why we can't use the drums that leak down on the launch pad. It's no longer potent enough. I need you to find an intact, shielded container of the igniting agent. As for the thrust control modules, they were custom built for these rockets. They won't even launch without them. All right, go on. Very well, we don't need a huge amount. 2 to 3 liters should be enough. Yes, that's isotope 239, all right. And there's enough here to launch the rockets. Now all I need is the thrust control modules. Repcon has been ransacked so many times by scavengers, it's hard to know where the components might turn up. If they turn up. Jason has mentioned some industrial ruins to the east that are supposed to be highly radioactive. Scavengers wouldn't know the value of the modules just by looking at them. If you know any junk dealers in the area, I'd start there. Bye.
What can I do for you? Yeah, and... Give me a shout if you need anything else.
Hi there. You might have noticed the very large building just north of here. Happy to do.
Subject E, diagnosis complete. Begin recording. My name is Whitley. I'm a researcher at Adams Air Force Base. Until recently, I was in charge of the DuraFrame reinforcement project for the combat model iBots. iBot DuraFrame Subject E is both the prototype and the last functional model in this test group. I was prepared to make several significant upgrades to the machines. However, as the project was cancelled and all DuraFrame assets are being diverted to Hellfire armor, I am sending this model to the Navarro outpost. If you're listening to this log from one of our Enclave outposts in Chicago. Give this unit whatever repairs it needs so it can continue to Navarro.
Fine by me.
So, you're back.
Thanks. Well, I'll give you a hint. They used to just call me Gibson. I hope you can figure out the rest. I don't mind, to be honest. Living long is a real accomplishment these days. Remains to be seen if I end up dying peaceful in my bed. The way I heard it, the Brotherhood of Steel ran the place before the NCR took it away from them. I'm not sure who started shooting first. But when it was over, the Brotherhood, with all their fancy armor and weapons, was on the run. Nobody's heard from them since.
Have you found the components we discussed? Indeed you did, and they seem to be in excellent condition. Very few. It is almost time for the great journey. Yes. We have everything we need to launch the rockets, Jason. The great journey can begin.
Gather all. May the Creator guide my words and help me speak true. The Almighty Creator has seen fit to answer our prayers. The time has come for us to board the rockets and begin the great journey. Though it may seem that all humans despise us, the Creator has seen fit to instruct us differently. The journey ahead would have been impossible if not for the intercession of two human friends, one new, the other a long-abiding companion. To our new friend, we say thanks and promise never to forget how we cleared from our path the demons who sought to stay our journey. But to Chris, we owe more than thanks. Chris, you have made this great journey a reality. From this moment forward, you will be remembered as the saint of the great journey. We shall never forget you. I ask that you forgive us, Chris, and give us your blessing. And we bestow ours upon you. Seekers, board the rockets. Take your seats. The great journey awaits. To the promised land we go. To the far beyond.
Hey.
Hello.
Did you hear him? My God, you were right all along. I'm no ghoul. They were just using me. And dying would be worse than this? Used up and thrown away like garbage? Oh. So I've redeemed the human race, is that it? What a crock. The human race can't stand me. So, you want me to accompany you on your adventures across the wasteland, is that it? Life among humans again? That's what you're suggesting? I guess it's the only chance I've got. Maybe it'll be different this time. I was never a saint before. I can't believe I'm agreeing to this, but I'll give it a try. You go launch the rockets. I'm on my way to Novak.
Thank you.
Hey there. Been to the top of the dino yet?
Oh, I'm already here. I guess my karma's so bad that stealing is nothing.
Welcome to Novak. It's not very exciting here, but the people are friendly enough. My engineering skills have been coming in handy, too. I've got plenty to do. Thanks for telling me about this place.
Maybe you made the right choice, but I'm gonna stop and keep me quiet. This weasel Benny's been twitchy since we stole that package from his boss, making me nervous as hell. But I found out we'd be passing through on our way to Boulder City. I was sure. McMurphy.
What's going on, man? I'm Manny. I'm on security detail here. You see a rifle barrel sticking out of the dinosaur's mouth, you got a 50-50 shot at me. Otherwise, it's Boone. You name it. Anything that comes within 1,000 yards that looks like trouble. Lately we've been getting ghouls, coming from the road to Repcon out to the west. Quite a few last couple days. The big threat is the Legion coming from the east. If they decide to attack with a full force, they'll run us over. But so far we've been lucky. Boone's a sniper, same as me. Used to spot for him when we were enlisted with the NCR. After we got out, I talked him into settling down here. So, here we are. I'd introduce you, but, me and his wife, we didn't see eye to eye on some things. And were they
welcome to Novak.
Well, butter my button car.
Likewise, friend, likewise. Is there anything old Vic can do you for?
Well, this ain't New Vegas, but I reckon you can find what you need here. Try the office out front. Don't rightly know. I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there. Novak? Nice enough place, I suppose, but between you and me, when I roll into town, my skin starts to itch. Watch yourself. No, don't believe I did. But you might ask around. The Novak folk usually see anyone traveling this way. Be seeing you. Hey there, friend. I'll let that slide, seeing as how you got a mind full of vengeance for that no good polecat and all. Be seeing you. Hey there, friend!
Okay, where's Boulder City? The hotel right there. Brother of Steel Hunter. Thank you.
Hello.
She hasn't paid me anything yet. Should I be worried?
What can I do for you?
Yeah, I'm about to just... Yeah, that it's not very useful. That gun.
Another satisfied customer. Thank you.
fish. Can't run from me.
Hey there.
What is it? I was in a lot of places with First Recon. I don't really remember. That part of my life, so... He was a good spotter. Yeah, we were. No. Sure. First NCR Recon. It's a sniper battalion. Sees a lot of action. They moved us around a lot. I was stationed at Camp Golf for a while. Last I heard, they're at Camp McCarran. They pick you out if you do well at the firing range. Pays a little better. So I said okay. Yeah, you can tell by the patch. Bear skull with crossed rifles behind it. Slogan underneath. The last thing you never see. Pretty accurate. And so are we. It was an airport before the war. Command liked it because it was already fortified and it let them keep an eye on the strip. They've got an old monorail that still runs between them. Used mostly for supplies and deployment. But if you get leave, you're allowed to go gamble. It was General Oliver's post. But I heard he's been up at the dam a lot lately. Guessing Colonel Shu is running it. Didn't know him. He's a signature on my discharge papers. Wasn't real popular, though. Even overheard my CO complain about him once. General Wait and See, he called him. Yeah. He introduced himself to me once. I shook his hand. Doubt he'd remember me now, though. When he looked at you, you could see he understood. After some of the things we'd seen, that meant something. But I heard he'd be a general right now if Oliver didn't know the president. Big one. The one the NCR is trying to hold on to, that the Legion's pushing for. Whole war depends on holding it. It was on the front line for a while. Only resort in New Vegas no one wanted to get sent to. Doesn't have that kind of importance anymore, though. They pulled most of the troops out of there after we took the Hoover Dam. Yeah.
I'm about to stop the stream for a second.